Okay, so I have another one, right? So keeping on the lines of dads and kids and whatever, right? So a dad and a child, and it was a dad in the park with his child, right? Mm-hmm. And so the kid had a toy, okay, and the kid didn't want to share his toy, and the dad said, "You don't have to share." Right? And strange. So there was another mother that was in the park, and she was so upset about this. She was like,
it was her child. Was it her child?
Because her child, right, she wanted her child. So, but according to psychologists, they said that the father was right. They said that the father was right, that you do not have to make your children share. They should not be forced to share. It's like you're taking
away. Why?
Because what you're doing is taking away the choice of your child because of what they say social norms are. And the child want to do it on its own, it should not be forced to do it.
Okay, because I did read that article where they were talking about all the reasons why. Like they said, oh, you know, adults, we don't share everything. So children shouldn't be forced to share everything either.
So then all that we learned before, so selfishness, all that stuff, that's what we're supposed to be.
You know what the thing is, though? I had issues with the article because I did get the sense that, yes, you need to give your kid a mm-hmm. sense of agency, right? And mm-hmm. be able to say, you know what? No, I choose to play with my toy. And the other kid needs to learn that you can't have everything that you want. Mm-hmm. Like, even though you want the toy that this person's playing with, you are not entitled to it. So I get that. But at the same time, I think that there are some kids who are just really selfish and never do want to share their toys.
But I think
they want their toys and your toys too. And so it becomes a line of, you know, when to say, okay, no, you actually do need to share because you need to learn everything's not yours.
But you know what's so crazy about that? Because just to like push the envelope a little bit, it's kind of the same thing that's happening in preschools and elementary schools about like kissing and hugging and touching and mm-hmm. what people are forced to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm trying to say? So all that stuff, we're just going to be like in little bubbles and everybody's going to have their own little...
Are you talking about whether they're talking about kids should not be forced to hug older adults? Or
no, each other. You know, like if a kid, like, you know, when little kids, when they start like kissing each other and they mm-hmm. try to kiss each other.
Oh my gosh, I had a little boy that like I had a crush on. I kissed him.
Right.
He hit me.
Right, but guess what? In today's society, if you just went and kissed that little boy, you have violated his personal space and rights, and his parents can...
I was five.
Yeah, they're five too.
I don't know. I think that's taking a little far. I get, again, yes, the personal space is a thing and it's real, but I think we're going after kids and trying to like...
I'm not making this up. It's my nephew, 5 years old. So he was kissing the girl. They was like, the mother, everybody's there. It's like a whole thing now. It's totally different. I don't know what we learned, but whatever we learned apparently was totally wrong.
Right. Well, I do think, yes, there are boundaries. Absolutely. Absolutely. Need to respect some boundaries, but
okay,
let's not put some kids in jail over.